Hi, I'm George from Epiphan Video, and today we wanted to take you through a quick 5-minute setup of Pearl Mini. The initial steps you need to take for networking, maybe some simple layouts, and really walk through the simple out-of-the-box experience. And then of course we have many other videos to expand on this that you can also check out. So here in front of me I have a Pearl Mini. I also have a laptop. These are the first two tools that I'll really need to get started. Of course, like anything, the first thing I need to do is to connect my power. So if we take a look at the back of the Pearl Mini, you'll see there is power, video inputs, audio inputs, everything on the back here. So I'll first connect my power. I'll power on the unit, and as Pearl starts to boot up, I'll then look at connecting my network. So of course for that I will need a network cable, so I have one here, and it is currently connected to my laptop. So let's go back to the Pearl Mini, and I will connect the network. And while I'm back there, I'm also going to connect my HDMI input. So with this, I have my power, my network, and a video signal all connected to the back of Pearl Mini. Now, as it boots up, I can wait for everything to come up on the front touchscreen. And as soon as it does, there's information that I can get from that front touchscreen. Some information would be, for example, the IP address of the unit, or even to assign a static IP address on the front of Pearl Mini, making it very easy for that initial network setup. So here in the front touchscreen of the Pearl Mini, we can get a little bit of information about our current network setup. By clicking on the gear icon, we can go into the menu system, look at the system status page, and it will give us information like the currently assigned IP address and the MAC address of this unit. If we need to change between a static IP address or DHCP address, we can also access that under the network menu to change between DHCP, static, and when we do static, we can enter a full address there. And this is a great tool for our initial network setup to get the Pearl up and running on our network. So on that front touchscreen, once we know that IP address, we can then use our web browser from a computer to access the Pearl over the network and get access to the full administrator interface, which we'll go ahead and look at now. So now that we know the network information from the front touchscreen of the Pearl Mini, I can then go over to my laptop and enter the administrative interface of that Pearl Mini. By default, the username is admin with a blank or empty password. So now that we have access to the Pearl Mini web browser interface, we have full control to change our channel settings, our encoding settings, recording settings, everything we might need in order to control this Pearl Mini. So for starters, we're going to take a look at our first channel, and you'll see that my HDMI signal is already showing up there. I have an overhead camera showing all of my gear here. I can look at encoding settings where I might want to make some initial changes to get my program up and running. So in this example, I'm going to be doing some custom layouts and some switching. So I'm going to first turn off the automatic frame size so that I can switch properly. I can then go and start creating some customized layouts. So this first layout gives my full overhead camera. I'm just going to quickly create a second layout with a couple of new items just to give us a little bit of a nicer look. I'm going to use this colorful background image so that we have some branding. So now that I have a background image loaded there, it has some branding, some color to it, I can now look at adding some video inputs. And so in this case, I'm going to use that same camera shot, but I'm going to frame it inside of this background image just so I have a little bit of a nicer look to it. And that gives me a little bit of branding for my content as well. And again, I can just use the simple click and drag interface to design my layout in any way that I see fit. I can save that layout and it's ready to go. And now when I'm ready to switch, I can do that here in the administrator interface or through the other switch methods on a Pearl Mini. You'll need to check out some of those other videos where we go into that a little bit more in depth with customizing layouts in the wide variety of ways, switching on the touchscreen and other forms as well. So that's a quick basic setup on the Pearl Mini. Power, network, video signals, web browser interface, really gets rolling very easily in a quick 5-minute setup. Thank you for joining us. Of course, like, subscribe, and follow Epiphan on Facebook and YouTube, Twitter, and all those other places. And keep an eye on this space for more upcoming Epiphan U videos, where we'll go more in depth on the advanced features of Pearl 2, Pearl Mini, and other Epiphan products. Thank you very much.